Move the camera back. We got a big one on the workshop today. AMT's much requested Haulaway trailer, 5-car automobile transporter. Check it out in 1/25th scale, old school type car transport trailer, which would fit perfect behind any of their vintage 1/25th scale semi-tractors. We saw my build of this auto car. Maybe we'll get it hitched up to that when we're all done. But first, let's take a look at all the plastic that will be in the box when you get yours. Giant slabs of styrene. Here's the bottom of the trailer. There's our fenders built in. Check out that nice tread. Cross beams. That's a big, big piece of plastic. You can see my hand there. We've got the sides to the trailer, which are just mirror images of each other. Thin styrene, but they do have some nice locating mounts and some nice mounting holes. I see no flash. I see nice tabs. We should be able to glue things nice and straight and square. And it's got excellent rivet designs all the way down either side. Like that. Printed on there. So we got two sides like that. Mirror images of each other. We got another deck here, looks like an upper deck for the trailer with that nice circle texture. We'll be able to do some chipping effects on that. Always, the paint's always wearing off those little circles there. We'll be able to do some dry brushing. You can see the rigid area back there. All right, let's get some more plastic out here. We got hubs, we got hydraulics for the area of the trailer back here that has to lift up to let the other cars out of the bottom rack, the two on the bottom. So we got the hydraulics for that. We got the hubs. We got, looks like, our kingpin right there. We'll find out if that's what that is. We've got some car hauler ramps. They got to be able to get them in the trailer on the different levels. So they got some nice long ramps that we can use if we choose. We got the back of the trailer with its outlines for all the taillights to glue into place. We got some nice little accessories here. We got one of the upper ramps, obviously based on these parts here and these parts here. This has to pivot somewhere or lock into place. This must be the rack to get up to the upper level of the trailer. They're all just guesses now, but we're going to find out when I glue this thing together. And then this tree here, we got this one here. I'm guessing this is where our kingpin mounts on the front of the trailer. We can see the hole there. We can see how it's molded nice and rigid, so it's got to be in the front of the trailer there. For the sides, nice detailing. And then we've got this tree here. We've got two position front dollies right there and right there. The landing gear can be raised or lowered. We got our suspension. We've got some airline hookups. We got some angle iron. We've got wheel chocks for all the cars. Nice little accessory parts. And we have our suspension. Now on the other side of the desk, of course, we're gonna have more fun stuff. We've got round two always gives out the big decal sheets with their rigs. We got the nice Auto World logos. We got the more modern reflectors. We got numerous license plates. We got fleet numbers in white and black. We got some really nice striping. City Car Releasing Company. We got American flags. We got state stickers. Yeah, it's a really nice decal sheet. Ready to go. All set up. We've also got a set of four tires. This trailer only has one axle. Nice looking tires. I think these are the redone ones that AMT Round 2 has put out. They were kind enough to send me this kit. These have no brand name molded into them. No white lettering or anything like some of the other ones had. Nice, we've got a steel axle, just so you know what's in there. In the bag, we've got our reflectors and our taillights and our ambers. Those are always handy, and you always have more stuff left over. And finally, one chrome tree with the decorative wheels. This one's a little bit of a fancier trailer, so it's got that. And then we've got these, what looks like steps or mold. We're going to find out what these little parts are. But these wheels always go together pretty nice. They're nice chrome. We're not going to have any issues there. So I'm going to start gluing stuff together, see how it all goes. I got to push stuff out of the way. The box is so big, and we'll be right back with a sub-assembly show-off. Getting the trailer assembled in about 90 minutes is pretty easy. You saw the pictures on how to line up the sides and all that. I do have tape across the top because I do not want to put this top on permanently right now with any glue. I need to be able to get inside the trailer to prime, to paint, and also to start doing my details for my idea for this build. So I just masking taped it in place, and this rear lifting platform that you can raise up to drive other cars underneath is just pushed in with hinges, and the sides will spread out super easy. So we've got all that set up right now, and I want to be able to paint everything and then put it together. We have the hydraulic rams. These go back here and they will actually hook in, and then there's other holes farther down, and you can see how that's going to raise up and down. Those glue together nicely and will still operate without issue. And there's plenty of play in there, so after you get paint on them, they're still going to move back and forth. You might scrape a little bit of the paint off moving them, but it won't be an issue. They line up really nice, and they're positively locked inside with a larger end on that ram, so it won't pull out for you either. It won't come too far. We've got the different size legs for raised or lowered. I'm just going to paint those as they are and swap them in and out as needed, and throw the spares inside the trailer when we're done. We got our loading ramps here. They're conveniently on one tree together. We can get those painted, detailed, weathered up a little bit, and ready to go. These are side steps for the side of the trailer. I'm not going to attach them at this moment. I have a little bit of an idea that I think I'm going to see if it works, so I want to leave them separately later. We got our wheel chocks all on one tree, cut off free. So those are set to be painted up as well. We got the brakes and hub all set. Now this will be getting painted. I don't know of any chrome brake drums. Man, those would really retain heat. So I'm going to paint those separately. The wheels I'm going to leave chrome. It's a nice model chrome. I'm going to be doing some other detailing to it, so I'll be leaving them alone. The trim ring on, or the ring on the inner side of the wheel, fits on nicely. They don't split or crack. Sometimes you'll get that once they're chromed. They do slide over nicely. They are held on, in my case, with super glue, and we can see no issues with fogging or details if you just are gentle with the super glue. It'll hold tight without causing any big sticky messes for you. So that is the wheels themselves. The trailer looks awesome. Takes up the whole screen there, front to back. We'll tilt it so you can see the whole darn thing. We got the front end of the trailer, which has our airline hookups. Those are glued in place with model glue. I'm glad that it all comes in white styrene, so you can paint it how you want, and also model glue adheres to AMT styrene like you wouldn't believe, and really gets it to weld together. We'll flip it over. We've got our rear axle here, or our only axle on the trailer, with our hubs and our dust shields, our springs, our brakes, and our air tank all glued on. Towards the front, we've got our landing gear, and then we've got our kingpin. Don't forget to glue that in solidly with model glue along with the landing gear. Get those in place, and then we can adjust the height on when we want to make it a hauler. But otherwise, you can see it assembles into a large, large open front trailer. Love the braces on there. Looks awesome. Like something a rich guy would use to haul his cars to the Mopar Nationals and all the cool stuff on there. Now let's take the ramp out. Be careful, because you don't want to pull too hard and snap these off, or you are up creek without a paddle. You'll have to rebuild them with pins. We'll take the tape off so we can see inside the trailer, and this will allow me to get things painted as well. I buy masking tape in bulk at a discount store, factory leftovers near me. I go through a lot of tape building this many models. Taking a look inside that trailer, you can see all the detail in there. Got the raised grooves. Boy, you don't want to drive off either side of those, do you? Get that guy's brand new Lamborghini, get his new Cuda, his Charger stuck. So that is the detail we've got inside, and now, like this, I'll be over to take it and get it in paint, so come along with. Thank you.
Thank you.
I wanted a well-used trailer, but not a completely shredded one, and that's exactly what I have here. We've got our weathering on it, we've got our flash rusting where the tire tracks go, and then we've got our dirt, and we've got our chipping where the paint has been rubbed off over the years from different chains and straps and tires going up and around it, and that new guy that always gives it too much gas and spins on the wet steel. He's useless, but I gotta keep him around because he's the boss's nephew. So we got the trailer all set up. It's still a great trailer, in excellent shape, still nice and strong and ready to be used. It's not all rusted and rotted through. It's just got a little wear and tear on it, but it's excellent for hauling cars. We got our wheel and tire package done. I black washed inside there, and that looks pretty awesome. Got our brake drums and hubs all set to go on the steel axle. Check out the wheel chocks. We'll just throw those in the bottom. Just got them a little dirty, left them there, nice kind of glossy, real rubber color. So those are all set. Now with the hydraulics, I did attach them and I just laid them in there so I can push things together. What I have to do at this point, or actually let's show you underneath as well before I flip it over. I've got the longer legs just tack glued on with some super glue. You can just pull those right back off and put the short legs on later if you want. But the way I'm going to display it, it's always going to be with the tires on so it sits level. Rarely going to have anything hooked up to it. I've glued on the steps on the side. Those are great. Got our indicator lights and our clearance lights all the way along the trailer. You saw how I put those on with just a little bit of super glue. Make sure you get all the spots. You have enough to do all your yellow lights and have two yellow lights left over. And you have just enough red lights to do the four tail lights on the back and the two after the axle marker lights on the back. That's it. You do not have any extra red, so do not lose them. But you can see the inside of the trailer, a little more damage because I haul cars on the bottom more often than they do the top. We got the straps and the chains that are always scraping paint off, so you've always got fresh metal. The front of the trailer in the upper will go on like so and will be super glued into place. We will then attach our hydraulic rams to the lower sections here. And then we just pry this apart real easy. This will fall in when I do that now. But we just pry that apart to get this in. We'll put the wheels and tires on it. I will decide off this awesome decal sheet. If I was doing a brand new trailer, I would totally use the black and red striping in the City Transporter. More modern trailer, you'd want to use this reflective tape, but I like the older look. So I'm not sure exactly which decals I'm going to use, but we have that awesome sheet here. When I get back, it will be all done. We'll see you soon. Big old trailer, another one that takes up the bench. This thing is nice. It's not as big, of course, as the more modern trailers. This older style is really awesome looking, though. We got the decals on. I went very simple, but I did want to call out the folks at AMT with their cool cat. I used the City Car Releasing Companies. I used the Wisconsin license plates. I had to use those on the back. Used the number 56. Took two of the numbers off the decal sheet as well to put 56 on the back. Used the reflector on the back with the red lens. Didn't use any of the more modern reflective tape underneath it. I like the older look. The plates from 72. So use some small logos and numbers, very minimal on this trailer. We're not going to go too fancy. You can see I've got the wheel chocks down inside of it, the ramps in the middle where you could just slide them on in, and then we've got the back ramp lifted up as if they're going to load underneath it when they pull the ramps out. Those will just lock into place when you pull them all the way up, or you can push them all the way back down. We'll have pictures of it both ways so you can see it as such, and in the pictures I will load it up with five AMT automobiles as well so you can see how it looks with different kinds of cars sitting on it. This will make for an excellent display case as well. You can put five cars on it in the space you'd only be able to fit about two, and you get a cool trailer to put them on so you can decorate it how you want. You could do it brand new, you can do it a little used like mine is, or you can really crust it out and leave it junkyard nasty. So any way you decide to build it, it's going to be a very easy, very quick build. I've only got about a day and a half in this. I could have got it all done the first day, but the yellow paint was taking a little bit longer to dry for me. It's a little bit humid this time of year, so it was taking a little bit longer, but if it would have dried right away, I could have banged this thing out in just one day, and I could have been done with the whole thing from taking it out of the box to painting it to weathering it with craft paints and having it all set. So excellent kit. This will be out soon. If not, by the time this video comes out, I will put links down in the description where you can get this on order or pre-order, depending on when you watch this video. Whether you watch it right away or watch it in the future will depend on whether this is in stock yet or not. But it is coming. The big Haulaway trailer in 1/25th scale from AMT holds 5 1/25th scale automobiles, would probably hold 5 1/24th scale as well. So don't worry about that size difference. And you can have it as the legs stowed up behind a trailer or the legs down so it can sit on your shelf or your desk display and display 5 of your most favorite models or rotate them through. Super easy build. First time kit builder could easily build this, and an experienced kit builder will have this thing assembled, painted, and detailed in such a quick time. This is a big slump buster kit. If you ever get overwhelmed by what you're working on, get out something like this, build it up. You're not going to have any problems with it, yet it's going to look really cool and very, very unique for a car hauler as it is. Thanks for watching the workshop. Always build your kits for you and have fun. You are the only one that matters when you're enjoying your hobby. Don't worry about the snobs and the haters. They don't ever build kits anyways. They just complain about yours. And we are having fun showing all the kits. And I love you guys coming on the workshop. Join us on Facebook as well. Show me your builds on Facebook. I like seeing what you guys are working on and what the current trends in the hobbies are. And we will see all of you at the next review.